हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द चैप्टर 6, हीट एंड टेम्परेचर। व्हाट इज हीट? व्हेन हॉट एंड कोल्ड ऑब्जेक्ट्स कम इन कॉन्टैक्ट विद ईच अदर, अ टाइप ऑफ एनर्जी फ्लोज फ्रॉम हॉटर टू द ऑब्जेक्ट टू द कोल्डर वन। दिस एनर्जी इज कॉल्ड एज हीट एनर्जी। अगेन आई एम रिपीटिंग द डेफिनेशन। व्हेन ए हॉट ऑब्जेक्ट कम्स इन कॉन्टैक्ट विद द कोल्ड ऑब्जेक्ट, टेक वन हॉट ऑब्जेक्ट। When your mama makes the food, she makes in vessel. So she take the food is being cooked. Now when she keeps the spoon inside, the spoon is cold. So the hot object, when it comes in the contact with the cold object, the energy flow from hotter object to the colder object. Then the spoon also gets heated up. This type of energy is called as heat energy. SI unit of heat energy is joule, that is J. It is capital J. Next, temperature. Temperature, the degree of hotness or the coldness of an object is called as temperature. Again, the degree of hotness or coldness of an object is called temperature. It is measured, the SI unit is Kelvin, that is K, capital K. Temperature is nothing but degree of hotness or the coldness of an object. Measurements of temperature. Our next topic is measurement of temperature. The instrument used to measure the temperature is thermometer, through which we can measure the temperature, that is thermometer. It consists of the following parts: bulb, stem and scale. Bulb, this is the part which actually touches the object whose temperature is to be measured. The bulb contains either mercury or alcohol. Okay, the bulb is the part which touches the object. Suppose if you want to take the temperature of our body, so the bulb will touch our body. Stem, it is a glass capillary tube through which the mercury or the alcohol rises or falls as the object around the bulb warms or cools. So stem, it is nothing but a glass tube in which the mercury flows, that is a capillary tube in which the mercury flows, that is it rises up or it falls. And the scale is marked on the stem to indicate the temperature of the substance. The scale is present on the stem, which indicates the temperature of the substance. Mercury used in the thermometer. Mercury is preferred in the most of the thermometer because it is present in the liquid states over a wide range of temperature. We use mercury because it is a liquid metal, and it gets easily, it is gray, silvery gray in color, so it is easy to observe. It does not stick to the glass container. It does not stick to the glass in which it is kept. Next, alcohol. If alcohol is used in the thermometer, the range of the temperature that can be measured using alcohol is less than 70 degrees centigrade. Alcohol is cheaper than mercury. Drawback of using alcohol in the thermometer is that the temperature above 78 degrees, it cannot be measured. Okay, it is measuring the temperature less than 70 degrees. Next, types of thermometer: clinical thermometer, digital thermometer, laboratory thermometer. We have three types of thermometer: clinical thermometer, digital thermometer and laboratory thermometer. Clinical thermometer. A clinical thermometer is used to measure the temperature of a human body. This thermometer is used in the hospitals or in the homes to measure the body temperature. The normal body temperature of the human body is 37 degrees centigrade or 98.6 Fahrenheit. If the temperature raises above 440 degrees centigrade, that is 0 degrees Fahrenheit, medical emergency requires. Then the person will require a medical emergency immediately. So this temperature, the temperature rises or falls under the state of illness. The capillary tube of the clinical thermometer has a bend which does not allow the mercury to flow back into the bulb before the temperature is read. So a bend can be seen at the bulb so that the temperature cannot go back. नेक्स्ट प्रिकॉशंस टू बी टेकन वाइल यूजिंग द क्लिनिकल थर्मामीटर. थर्मामीटर शुड बी वॉश्ड बिफोर एंड आफ्टर द यूज विद एन एंटीसेप्टिक लोशन. इट शुड बी इंश्योर्ड दैट मर्क्यूरी कम्स बिलो 35 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड और 95 डिग्री फारेनहाइट. द थर्मामीटर शुड बी रेड कीपिंग द लेवल ऑफ द मर्क्यूरी अलोंग द लाइन ऑफ साइट. ओके इट शुड बी एट द लाइन इट शुड बी द थर्मामीटर शुड बी एट द आइस सो अलोंग द लाइन ऑफ साइट. If the thermometer should be handled with the care, otherwise if it hits again a hard object, it can break. The bulb of the thermometer should not be touched while taking the reading, while taking the reading, and hold the thermometer with the glass body. Next, digital thermometer, that is electronic thermometer, is called the digital thermometer. These do not contain mercury. There is no risk of mercury being released on the breakage. And the temperature is easier to read in this type than the conventional thermometer, because in the digital type of thermometers, what will happen? The temperature readings are written in the form of digits. The word digital means digit. Next, laboratory thermometer. Laboratory thermometer is used in the labs for during the experiment. The range of the thermometer in the laboratory that can be measured is -10 to 110 degrees centigrade. So we can use these thermometers in the labs. So it measures the range from -10 degrees to 110 degrees centigrade. Next, precautions to be taken while using the laboratory thermometer. Handle the thermometer with care. If it hits against the hard object, it can break. So same precautions what we have done in the clinical, same the precautions in the laboratory thermometer. So it should be handled with the care, otherwise if it hits a hard object, it can break. We should not hold the thermometer through the bulb. We should hold it through the glass body. The thermometer should be kept in the upright position. It should not be in the tilted form. It should be in the upright place. It should be kept upright, but it should not be tilted. The bulb should be surrounded from all sides by the substance of which the temperature has to be measured. So you have to dip the bulb in the solution so that you can measure the temperature of that solution. The bulb should not touch the surface of the container. So the bulb should not touch the bottom of the container. Removing the thermometer from the boiling point and then immediately immersing it in the ice bath may cause the thermometer to break. So if you have taken out the thermometer from the hot solution, now you cannot keep the thermometer in the cold solution because it can break due to the temperature difference. Next, temperature scale. There are three different temperature scales that we can use for measuring, that is Celsius scale, Fahrenheit scale and Kelvin scale. Okay, Celsius scale, it was developed by Anders Celsius. The units are degree centigrade, and on this scale the division falls between the freezing point of water is taken as 0 degrees and the boiling point of water is taken as 100 degrees centigrade. 0 degrees centigrade is called as lower fixed point, 100 degrees centigrade is called as upper fixed point. So the freezing point of water is 100 freezing point of water is 0 degrees and the boiling point of water is 100 degrees centigrade. Next, Fahrenheit scale, it was developed by Daniel Gerbel Fahrenheit. The unit is degrees Fahrenheit. The freezing point of water is 32 degrees Fahrenheit and the boiling point of water is 212 Fahrenheit. So lower fixed point is 32 Fahrenheit and the upper fixed point is 212 Fahrenheit. Next, Kelvin scale. It was developed by Lord Kelvin. The unit is K. The freezing point of water is 273 Kelvin and the boiling point of water is 373 Kelvin. This scale, Kelvin scale, is called as the absolute scale of temperature. Why? Because 0 Kelvin is the absolute zero. 0 Kelvin is the absolute zero, and this is the lowest attainable temperature in the universe. See, the freezing point is the freezing point in the Kelvin scale is 273. The freezing point is 273. So 0 Kelvin is very much less than 273. So that is an absolute zero. This is the lowest attainable temperature in the universe. Next, conversion of scale. We have two different formulas for the conversion of scale. The three temperature of the scale can be converted from one form to the other by using these formulas. Fahrenheit is equals to degree centigrade into 9 by 5 plus 32, or we can convert degree centigrade into Fahrenheit. That is, degree centigrade is equals to Fahrenheit minus 32 into 5 by 9. Similarly, Kelvin to degree centigrade, we can measure Kelvin is equals to degree centigrade plus 273, or degree centigrade is equals to 273 minus Kelvin. So these are the two formulas which you have to learn. Okay, and now I'm going to end my session till here.